Last night, someone sent me a digital poster on Viber. And it was a poster with a silhouette of the cross on the foreground and the rising sun in the background. Meron siyang caption at ang nakasulat, "Only Jesus could bridge heaven and earth with just two pieces of wood." I smiled when I read the caption. I said, maybe he was sending me the poster because he heard me last Friday talking about the two lines of the cross as signifying the two most important commandments according to Jesus. The vertical, signifying a wholehearted love of God, and the horizontal, signifying love of neighbor as oneself. I found myself saying, oo nga, how true. The cross is indeed our bridge. Ang krus ay ang ating tulay. Ito ho yung good news na gusto kong ibahagi sa inyo ngayon. This is the good news that I wish to share to you today as we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Lent. You know that in the Catholic Christian tradition, we call it the Laetare Sunday or the Sunday of rejoicing. Why should we be rejoicing if we are about to commemorate the passion and death of Christ, which the cross is supposed to symbolize? Well, you have your answer in today's gospel. The cross is not about suffering and death. The cross is not a morbid message. It is a good news. Ang krus ay mabuting balita. And the good news is this: there's a bridge. Does that remind you of an old song entitled Bridges, sung by Diane Reeves? It was also sung by Sergio Mendes. But the young people here would not remember this song. The song says, "There's a bridge to tomorrow. There's a bridge to the past. There's a bridge made of sorrow that I pray will not last. There's a bridge made of color in the sky high above. And I pray that there must be bridges made out of love." Yun yung kanyang last line. "I pray," ang sabi niya, "that there must be." At ang sagot ko sa kanya ay ganito, "Don't say there must be. There is a bridge made of love. And we call it the cross of Christ." Sa Gospel of John, the cross does not stand for defeat. It stands for victory. Kaya nga, in the Catholic Christian tradition, we celebrate a feast that we call the Exaltation of the Cross. Ang pagtatanghal o pagtatampok sa krus. And we don't celebrate that day glorifying a morbid symbol, which was a cruel instrument of torture. What we glorify, rather, is God's eternal love that is willing to pay the price, even if it would mean being ready to suffer and to die. It is about an unconditional love that is willing to go down to hell for the sake of the beloved. Today's gospel is my answer to many Catholics who still think of God as a punishing God. Ewan ko lang, ang daming Katolikong masyadong takot sa Diyos, takot na sila'y parusahan o itapo ng Diyos sa impyerno. The common notion is, mahal lang ng Diyos ang mababait. God loves only the good and the righteous people, and He judges the sinners and the undeserving. Actually, this is the most common presupposition of most religions about salvation. Most religions would have a notion of salvation, and it is founded on a basic sense of retribution, reward for the good, punishment for the wicked. And like I keep telling you, wala namang likas na masamang tao dito sa mundo. If there is anyone who has challenged this kind of thinking about salvation, it is Jesus Christ. And it is what John is proclaiming in today's gospel. Favorite ito ng maraming Kristiyano. John 3:16. For God so loved the world, He gave us His only Son, so that all who believe might not perish, but might have eternal life. My only disappointment is, usually, memoriado nila ito, verse 16, and they stop there. Eh, meron pa siyang kasunod, verse 17. At narinig ninyo sa gospel ngayon. Verse 17 says, God did not send His Son to the world to condemn the world, but to save it. Hindi raw sinugo ng Diyos ang anak niya dito sa mundo para husgahan, para hatulan ng daigdig, kundi para iligtas siya. In short, it is not God's business to condemn. Ang misyon ng Diyos ay ang magligtas. God's mission is to save. Kaya nga, ang pangalan ni Christ ay Jesus. In Hebrew, Yeshua. Yehoshua. Na ang ibig sabihin, God saves. The Lord saves. If He must give up His life, He would gladly do it for love of us. There is a term for that kind of salvation that has to be paid for a huge price. Redemption. Redemption. And it is what the cross stands for. You know, I think this is the whole background to what St. Paul is saying to the Romans. Another favorite passage ng marami, Romans 8, verse 31. If God is for us, who can be against us? Kung ang Diyos nasa panig natin, sinong kalaban natin? And then he goes out of his way to strike out all the possible answers to his question. Sa verse 32, para bang sinasabi niyang, how can you even think that God will be against you? when he did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else with him? And he goes on to say, who will bring up charges against you? I like the idea. Parang, sino magdidemanda sa'yo? Who will bring up charges against you? Si God? Come on. It is God who acquits us. And then he asks again, so, sino kinatatakutan ninyo? Who are you afraid of? Who will condemn you? The Son of God? But his whole mission was precisely to offer his own life for our salvation, to intercede for us. So why will he condemn you? Hindi pa nga siya pinapako sa krus. Sinabi na niya dun sa woman caught in adultery, I do not condemn you. And then, he drops the most important question like a bombshell. Ang sabi niya, who can separate us from the love of God? Sinong makapaghihiwalay sa atin sa pag-ibig ng Diyos? Ano ang sagot niya? Nothing. Nothing. Wala. Bakit? Because of his confidence in the love of God as revealed to us in Jesus Christ. And you know, this is one of the most radical statements in the whole Bible for me. If separation from the love of God means hell, and by the way, yun naman ibig sabihin ng impyerno. Ewan ko lang, masyado lang tayong nasanay dun sa apoy. E para bang isang lugar, babarbecuehin daw ng demonyo ang masasama. That's just art. Baka nga walang apoy sa impyerno eh. Hell is separation from God. If God is the God of life, and we get separated from life, we're killing ourselves. Now, if separation from the love of God is what hell is about, that is almost as good as saying, God will never damn you to hell. Hindi ka kailanman itatapon ng Diyos sa impyerno. Bakit? Eh kasi mahal niya tayo eh. Pwede mo bang papagdusahin yung minamahal mong hindi ka rin magdurusa? Ngayon, ano ba yung sinasabi natin dito? Are we saying walang impyerno? Is there no hell? Oh no, come on. Alam natin, may impyerno. Ang dami ng taong hindi pa sila namamatay, impyerno na yung buhay nila eh. May impyerno, there is hell. Except that nobody will throw us to hell except ourselves. St. John is saying it too in today's gospel. He says, we condemn ourselves by our own disbelief, our own stubbornness of heart, our own deliberate choice to stay in darkness than live in the light. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Walang makapaghihiwalay sa atin sa pag-ibig ng Diyos, kundi sarili natin. Our own refusal to respond to the love of God, our own choice to live only for ourselves. Yun ang impyerno. Kinakanta natin yan sa pananagutan. Walang sino man ang nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang. And I object. Ang sabi ko, hindi totoo yan ha. Ang daming tao dito sa mundo nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang. At yun ang impyerno, to live only for oneself. Kaya ang biro ko nga eh, lahat tayo pupunta ng langit. But the bad news is, hindi tayo lahat magiging maligaya sa langit. At yun ang impyerno. Hindi ba impyerno yun? Nasa langit ka na, hindi ka pa maligaya. Well, I have good news for you. The good news is, even hell is not beyond the reach of God. Kung sakasakaling mahulog man tayo doon, the good news is, hell is not beyond the reach of God. And I assure you, sabi ko nga kanina, we are such experts in making a hell out of our lives on earth. Anong ibig sabihin ng hell is not beyond the reach of God? Hindi ba? Every Sunday, nire-recite natin yung Apostles' Creed. At hindi ba may isang linya dun sa ating pagpapahayag ng pananampalataya? He descended into hell. Ang anak ng Diyos, bumaba sa impyerno. I used to react to that when I was a kid. I remember asking my mother, bakit ho bumaba ng impyerno si Jesus? Hindi ba? Wala naman siyang kasalanan. Hindi ba mga kampun lang ng demonyo ang bumababa sa impyerno? My mother didn't know how to answer me. Ang sabi niya, punta ka doon sa pare para malaman mo yung sagot sa tanong mo. Siguro kaya ako nagpare. I wanted to know why Jesus went down to hell. Salamat sa Diyos at naituro naman sa akin sa seminaryo. Gusto niyong maintindihan kung ano ang impyerno? Do you understand what hell is like or what it is like to be in hell? Tumingin ka lang sa krus. Mukha bang langit yan? Does that look to you like heaven? To be condemned to death by the very people you want to save? To be treated like a criminal for the sheer crime of being compassionate, of loving unconditionally? Sa akin, that is the best image of the God who descends into hell for love of us. And the good news is, there's a bridge, not just between heaven and earth. There is also already a bridge between heaven and hell. And the bridge is the cross. A few days ago, tumanggap ako ng regalo. It was a gift from Bishop Broderick Pabilio. Bishop, salamat ho. It was the day before my birthday, so I took it as a birthday gift. Pero wala naman siya na sinasabing happy birthday. It was a metal pendant cross on a chain with the name of Jesus engraved on it in the ancient Tagalog baybayin script. And it came with a letter explaining what it was for. And he explained that he was encouraging Filipinos as we celebrate the 500th year of the arrival of Christianity in the Philippines by proudly wearing our crosses. Not as a fashion statement, but as a theological statement. And I agree with him. On that day of March 31, 1521, when the first Mass was celebrated on the shore of Limasawa, the very first Christian icon that our ancestors were introduced to was Ay, hindi ho Santo Niño. Pangalawa yun. That happened at the first baptism. The first icon we were introduced to was the cross. And the bearers of the cross, the Spaniards, also brought with them another cross. The cross of colonial rule. The cross of oppression, which we eventually rejected, repudiated. Eventually, we threw away that cross of oppression because we learned to embrace the true cross of freedom, of liberty, the cross of redemption, the cross of God's unconditional love, the cross that gives us human beings our true dignity as the sons and daughters of God. And so, we look back and we say to ourselves, despite all the pain that we have had to go through, we will forever be grateful for this cross. We will no longer be motivated by the fear of a punishing God, that God is not true. We will no longer be afraid of the deep chasms, mga bangin, that need to be traversed or crossed to get to the beyond, the hereafter. Bakit hindi tayo dapat matakot? Because there's a bridge. There's a bridge made of love. And the bridge is the cross of Christ.
There's a bridge to tomorrow. There's a bridge to the past. There's